All right. Let's see. Let's just right. I'm gonna switch the luchador out. The luchador is cool, but he's not cool enough. Not for me right now. Anyway, yeah. Welcome back. We're doing more has-been heroes, obviously. All right. Optimum routes are the hardest thing in this game. Okay, we got this. I just always have to look that first time, see, like, is there an optimum way through here? I should probably get my head in the game instead of just thinking about whatever. Not much to do. Just have her go up here. Bard up. Bard attack. Let's see. Might as well just double his attack up, stun him, and go from here. Okay, starting to know. Oh, crap. I apparently took too long to hit him through his stun. Well, that's annoying. Probably should actually move the bard down here a little bit and start clearing out this line. Or not the bard, the other dude. Man, I'm just the worst today at braining. Okay, so who's even on the chopping block here? Oh yeah, backstab damage is a thing. I keep forgetting about that. Uh-oh. We might get clobber knotted here. Pause. Okay. Let's see. Do that. Unfortunately, we have no way of undoing the time here. Okay. Let's have him smack him back. Oh, there's another one. There's another skeleton right there. That's not what I wanted to do. Oh, and that resets her combo meter. That's rough. Okay. I can't do much about this right now. You know what? Let's just start over. That's a really bad hand to start off with, and I don't want to deal with it. Let's see. This game looks interesting. Torn between this or the Shovel Knight bundle. Honestly, I'd probably say the Shovel Knight bundle is probably the better deal. At least given the situation. Don't get me wrong, I like it, but Shovel Knight is really hard to beat. I do really enjoy this game, though. It's really clever. Okay. Let's see, so we've frozen them. So in that case, I'm just gonna make the most of this. Yeah, I always forget, when they're frozen, when they're frozen, or stunned in any way, shape, or form, you get to freely, just beat them down, which is super handy. Well, one way or another, we kill that guy? Yeah, perfect. Okay, attack, you move up, and just smack him around. Yeah, we got this. Not perfectly, but we got this. At least better than last time. It just takes a bit for me to remember how the combos, specifically work in this game. And that'll probably be kind of normal here. The mechanic for this game is so unique and interesting that it's like, I just automatically become rusty the moment I stop playing it for a little while. I'll probably get better at it, don't get me wrong. But still, hard thing. Okay, let's see, knock him around. I mean, he doesn't even do any damage, but that's fine. Okay, so now we've got... Might as well splash him to death. Smack him around. Yeah, everything feels good. Okay. Unfortunately, my bard is still kind of this, like, non-functional character. Though, I don't actually remember. I want to say the wizard dude from my first couple runs was kind of equally worthless. I don't remember him being particularly good. Oh, they have like a health regen. Okay. That's good to know. I didn't notice it, but some of the guys were healing through their like the fire damage. Okay, so that means damage over times are not as reliably useful. I'm just gonna have her chew through him, I guess. So I think this will work. Ah! Dang it, it didn't. Well, I'll kill that one at the very least. Knock him up. Knock him back, stun him, and we're good to go. Yeah, but I don't know, I really appreciate, this game. It's, yeah, not as good as Shovel Knight, but it's really hard to pick a game that would be better than Shovel Knight. I guess the easy example would be, I personally like Hollow Knight a fair bit more than Shovel Knight. Okay, move up, move up, move up. Kill him, perfect. Yeah! Monk and the Bard have about the same damage. Just like the Monk's starting spell and buffs better. I don't know which I like better. I really like the Bard's AoEs, because they can be used for a lot more, like, cheat nonsense. Oh, wow, he's got a fair amount of stuff. Wait, why my inventory, my UI changed around, so it goes candle, money, and then key now. That's different. Okay, okay, so we have Scepter of the Nameless, which is good for spell recharge, max health and melee damage. We don't know what that mushroom does. Well, we have money. So let's have her pick up the miner's tools. Increasing her melee damage seems like a good idea. And then I'm gonna have him pick up the mushroom. Spell recharge, oh, but reduces, yeah. I don't know if this is a good idea. Well, hopefully we don't find a spell merchant immediately. Though we might be able to switch around. Okay, so we do have a water spell vendor. Okay, so I only have one candle here. I might have just screwed myself there. Out of this. We haven't taken any stamina damage. I really wish I hadn't bought that mushroom. Well, I'll go this way. If I can get one more candle from this battle somehow, we'd be golden. Okay, I'll just smack him around for the time being. Not perfect, but it'll have to do. Yeah, because we want those water spells. The monk's perks are good. Oh. Yeah, the monk's perks are good, but they're not that good. I mean, honestly, once we've actually gotten to the point where, once we've gotten to the point where, we know what every item does. Oh, crap. He came back. Let's see. Move him down and around. Once we know what every item does along the way here, this'll get a lot easier. Because then I won't make the mistake of buying, say, the spell, you know, wasting all of my money figuring things out. It's just until then, not exactly my most, my proudest strategies. That makes sense. Okay. Kinda wanna just hot potato the lot of these guys. Well, let's smack him around, move her down, hit the next guy. Him around. Yeah, it's not perfect. It'll be fine. I guess I'll just knock that guy back, even though it really doesn't make much of a difference right now. Bard up. Okay. I should probably pay a little bit more attention to future combos. Eventually, I'll be able to set everything up just by looking. Let's see. So we want to move him up, and yeah, that's good. Okay, do we have any water spells that we can specifically do? Does that take him out? No. See if I can. I wanted to stun him right before he showed up, but did not succeed. Ah, oh, you serious? Oh, that guy's stamina recharges way faster than the other ones. That would do it. Okay, what do we have? We almost have enough soul power. I don't know if soul power, specifically charges fast enough. Okay, Bard, you. Okay. I don't even know who I'm smacking around here. And it's not working great. Okay. It's kind of a problem, actually. Just gonna move her there. We got too many enemies getting a little bit close for comfort. And it's an issue. Stunned. Well, this guy only has, like, a smidge of HP. So maybe I can get this to work. Okay, he's dead. He's dying. And I'm gonna hot potato that guy. Should give us enough time. Wow, that dude has some range. Okay. Yeah, this is the problem. We're not quite strong enough here to justify some of these, or not justify some of these fights. We don't quite have enough strength to, like, get past them. Oh, we did get a second candle, and we do have enough money. And we do have a locksmith. Okay. So we're gonna go to the water spell vendor. Going this way, we'll use one candle. Good! So they took that, that criticism. Okay. I see, so we've gotta have the bard go in, but that's fine. Yeah, hopefully we get one of the good hydromancies. Oh, that's a new one. Whatever this does. Okay, water damage, 40 to 50, target is soaked, causes target to fear and run away for 5 seconds. Ooh! Okay, that's useful. Still no puddles, but that's fine. Okay. Yeah, so they added a confirmation so you don't kill yourself with the candles. That's good, that was one of my major complaints. As far as playing through this game goes. Oh, they also increased the price of keys pretty dramatically. Well, I'll have to live with it and hope for the best. I don't have any keys. Okay. Lightning spell vendor. This is not going great. I think as a general rule, I'm gonna have to start mandating I always have at least 200... We always have at least 200, gold. And several keys, apparently. Because, yeah, she... Oh, good. We did get a key. We got two keys, in fact. Alright. Whatever that is, it looks castery. I could be wrong. Liquid electricity. Increased crit chance. 50% chance to get lightning spells from any spell vendor. That's... not great. I don't know if it's any good. We'll see. Okay, a lot of dudes. Let's see. A lot of painful dudes. Okay, so we want to try this on this guy. Okay, so we're going to have him run away in fear. Probably could time that a little bit better. Honestly. Oh, it's an AoE. Awesome. So it will knock all of them away. Okay, this guy has 80. This guy's got 52. If I can take him out, that makes life easier. Okay. So 1, 2. Perfect. And we're just gonna have her wait and knock this guy back. Oh, just straight up kills him. Nice. Unfortunately, the bard's charge time isn't the greatest. I guess that doesn't matter too much. Okay, let's do a double strike and take this guy out. Yeah, there we go. We do just enough damage to almost kind of justify it. Okay. I guess we can move the bard up here. By the time the bard's done, this guy can be ready to take him out the rest. Well, not the rest of the way. Part of the way. And what is the cooldown? Oh, wow, the cooldown's only like 15 seconds on that. Awesome. Yeah, so we're in a pretty good spot here. Might as well stun the lot of them. Wait for the fire to go away. That is not a long burn time. Let's wait. Might as well stun this guy. And move her in, because I think melee damage is per hit. But I could be wrong. I'm just gonna hit him even though it doesn't really matter. Okay. Yeah, none of the guys on top have any stamina, so that puts us in a nice position for demolishing my foes. Well. Oh, it's oh no, it grabs all of them. That's awesome. So the guy that you fear runs all the way back. And he takes his friends with him, and then they stay stunned. That's kind of incredibly useful, to be totally honest. Actually, come to think of it, we'll just do this. She should be able to just take him out the rest of the way. Yeah? Yeah, good stuff. Alright, is that the end of the enemies? Yeah. So, doing a little bit better now. We just needed a little bit of a spell. We needed a spell, honestly. Okay, so what do we got? We've got potato for spell recharge. And we've got spell recharge. Well, they're both affordable. Do we want to do it for, like, crate? Sure. Screw it. I don't know. We should make plenty of money. Let's see. The bard is actually a hero? How does the bard survive? By hiding behind everybody else. Okay, so I don't even know what... I wonder if there's a cooldown minimum. No, you know what? I have no idea. It says cooldown 15, but that's the base cooldown, so I actually have no idea what the logic is behind how that like specifically works. Okay, well, let's try finding the boss. We've got a second spell, so we should be able to kick ass pretty hard here. Oh, it's this guy. Well, this will be fun. I actually really like fighting this boss. Okay, so he's stunned for a moment. Good stuff. Okay. This is quite possibly one of the most interesting bosses you could send at me. I don't know. I think it's really clever. And seeing as we've got some, like, crazy short cooldowns, I'm just gonna make him run in fear for a second while we pile drive his goons. Okay, pause. Water that one. Oh! Okay, that's good to know. Well, he's invisible. We can't do... Well, he's invisible, he gets all of his stamina back. Might even regain one? I'm not entirely sure. Okay. And, of course, he's gonna move locations. Luckily, we can move... okay. That's hot potato. Only hits one of them. Oh! Okay. Not... Great. Oh, right! We've got the sneak attack bonus to work from. Okay, come on. So we're gonna... double cast that, hit him twice, and... I mean, we're pretty much golden. This dude does not have a chance at this point. Fortunately, he's immune to, fear effects. Oh. And he's invisible again. Okay. At least I think he's invisible? He looks like he was. Okay. So as long as he doesn't move, I think we've got him on the run here. Is that it? He's not done yet. Wow. This guy is, hanging on by a thread. Let's just do that. Where is he moving? Okay, he's moving there. I'm just gonna have her move down and hit him. Ah, it didn't work. Okay, let's do... double cast, hit him with a stun. And she should have plenty of time. Yeah, because we're doing... Oh, hey, candle and money, of course, and a key. Nice. Because we're doing backstabs, we're taking out the shades along the way, which is great. Okay, so how are we doing this one? Welcome to the desolation. So if I go down... No, we want to go up and then down and around. We're going to miss out on one unless I candle. Yeah, okay. So we want to go up. Yeah. The only thing that would maybe change my mind is if I had a battle. Okay, so we have multiple chests and one's locked, but this time around I got plenty. Okay, so what's the plot for this game? The plot for this game is kind of simple. We're escorting the two princesses in the back to school, but for the most part it's more of a fight waves of enemies off and have fun with it. I don't know. I really appreciate it. It's just weird. I do like how the one guy does have, like, just a giant sword, and he is one-handing it like a champion. Okay, yep. Well, that didn't work out the way I wanted it to, but that's fine. Well, let's just murderize that guy, and this guy. Let's murderize all the guys. Okay, I'm only gonna be able to kick this guy back, but that's fine. Bard should be able to finish him off. Oh, did that wrong. Well, that's okay. I guess let's hot potato Captain Demon Man. Switch. Yeah, so I'm just gonna keep knocking this guy away until I can figure it out properly. I mean, we could also make him afraid. Okay, so we want to have her go here, him go here. Him attack, her attack. Oh, there was somebody else. Oh, it was probably a Skellabob. Now that I'm thinking about it. Not much I can do here. Let's see. Okay, good. Got her just before it went away. And while we're at it. Oh, so they do keep all of their stamina while fleeing. Good to know. I wasn't sure if that would work the way I thought it was going to work, and the answer is, not really, but that's also fine. Okay, we might as well just water him to death. Yeah, I really like going pure caster builds on the bard. Like, the monk has some good features. You're not wrong with that original assessment, random audience member. But at the same time, I love having the extra DPS available from Murder Bard. Okay, did he just go down? I think he just went down. Alright. You know, we might as well hot potato him. That actually takes off his stamina meter. Awesome. We can also make him run in fear, because he might be one of the last enemies? I have no idea. I'm just gonna give it some time. Okay, so let's wait until double hits going. Cast it on her. Move him up. Give him the smackadoo, and we wait. Okay. Interestingly enough, he didn't know. Did he lose the maximum stamina there? I have no idea. But yeah, we do want to take him out beforehand. Okay. Unfortunately, you can't juggle enemies in the air, which is something that I'm kind of I don't know. I don't hate it, but like, what other game was I playing recently? Oh, 10th Line. 10th Line had a really good like enemy juggle system that you could work with. And it was fun to play. Okay, so we have an item gambler. Now, to some degree, I kind of want to save my cash. Item gambler is pretty cheap, though. Any luck? No dice. Okay. And we get this. Max health and spell recharge. I really wish I could pass that to other characters, but that's fine. And we still have 200. We still have 200 gold plus and other things. Okay. So what are we up against? I guess we might as well start easy with the double strike and smack him around. These guys are a little bit on the tougher side. I'm just gonna smack this guy back for the time being. Luckily, we've got couple of things to work with. Like a hot potato for that guy. Okay, that does... Yeah, actually... Oh, yeah, so being on fire takes off some of my stamina. But not a big deal. Crap, I did this wrong. No. Wait, we want to move her there. Okay, because that guy's stamina meter isn't going to drop that quick. Okay, and nothing fancy that I can do here. We'll just hit him around a bit, and we're pretty much golden. Just gotta not spend too much time here. Futzing around. The dude that goes invincible is a bit concerning. How much HP does he have? A lot more than I thought he was going to. Okay. Actually, we might as well make him afraid. No, does he hurt everybody else? No, he just scares them. Okay. That's a good little point to know. The fear spell only damages one of them. Well, I only can see one of them for the time being. Let's see, move him down. I guess there's wannabe... Oh, wait, no, it's not wannabe Kratos. He just has a heart. Let's see, we want to move him up. Okay, there we go. Are we going to get it? No. Let's toss a potato and stun them all. Hit him wrong. I'm hitting everybody wrong. I'm just gonna cycle people and accept that I screwed up. Okay. And she might be able to hit him in the back while he flees. Okay, could have done that better now that I'm thinking about it. Double cast, knockback, move her down, bard up, and we're good. Okay, his enemies are getting a little close for comfort here. Which I'm not exactly keen on. Not much to do there. Like, he's almost dead. Just a little bit more and we're good. Okay. Heck, I could probably have the bard finish him off. But we want the bard there for that. Okay, and we're good. We got plenty of spells to maybe... make it work. Did it get him? No, I didn't get him. Well, let's hold on. One moment. Okay. Fear. Okay. That worked better than expected. That fear spell is going to be incredible. Let's see. Because it decimates a whole lane. Like, they can't deal with it. It's beautiful. Okay, let's try this again. That didn't really work out the way I wanted it to. Kind of wasted that one. Ooh, hot potato. Hot potato! Oh. Squandered that one, too. Well, that's fine. Okay, so let's get back on track instead of trying to make things work. Let's just accept that we failed to some small degree. And do things the right way. There we go. Life's looking good. Unfortunately, we can make it work. I will say the music is starting to get a little bit repetitive on me. Though I don't know if there's much to do. Oh, shoot, we ran out of time. I guess we did send them all running back instead of actually fighting them. So that is a detriment of sorts. Okay, so locksmith. Might be a little bit pricey for me. How many candles do I have? A billion. Okay, so I can buy... Let's buy one key. Because, yeah, 4 gold was definitely too low for the amount of money we threw into keys. Okay. I'm just going to start chewing through them early. Okay. I'll probably chuck a hot potato at these guys. Not much else we can do here. Yeah, originally I was really afraid of, using hot potato, on enemy groups. Because I was really worried that hot potato, like, I was gonna hurt my own guys with, friendly fire. Turns out that's actually not really a concern, which is kind of really cool. I'm just gonna knock that guy back. Unfortunately, we just don't do damage. Okay, seeing as we've got Riptide, that guy is 71. Nope, that's the wrong one. Oh, actually, no, this guy just had a ton of extra HP. I'm just gonna use that to finish that guy off, even though that seems like a gross waste of resources. it doesn't matter too much. These dudes with the hearts are annoying. They put up like an invincibility shields, which is inconvenient to say the slightest. I don't know, whatever. We're good. Oh crap, zombie. I'm just here to kick the shit out of that zombie. Guess we might as well throw some fire that direction. Okay, good. And we probably want to move her back down, because this guy's going to be an issue. Knock the zombie back, kick the plant in the face, and hit this guy as hard as we can. That's probably a good candidate for why we want to use hot potato on enemies. Okay, let's move them around. I don't know if enemies actually naturally get stamina back, now that I'm thinking about it. That's an interesting question. Okay, so he actually, that's a pretty weak zombie. This is actually a really weak zombie. Not much there. I'm just gonna keep her there. Okay, zombie's dead. Life is good. Let's kill that guy. Orb dude's a problem. But not that big of a deal. Because he's on... Well, that guy's on fire. This guy's gonna go right here. And we've still got plenty of time to finish this level before we run out of time and don't get as much of a reward. Because I like that reward. I like getting as much cash and items and whatever as possible. Otherwise, it just feels like a darn waste. Okay. Yeah, I think eventually I might have to unplug my own headphones from my TV for this game, just because the music is super repetitive. I play my own, but the last time I tried experimenting with that... there we go. Yeah, the last time I tried experimenting with that with console, it just did not go well. Okay. Weird key that costs 50 gold, better than 99 for 4 gold each. So, they actually changed it. So, you can't buy, keys for 4 gold anymore. So it's always best to pick up the weird key for 150 gold. Like, they boosted the prices of all keys. Okay, so spell and melee. And we don't know what that one does. Well... Spiky suspenders. Let's see. So do we go for even more spell cooldown? Yeah, we'll do it. It doesn't really get a whole lot of spell cooldown to begin with. Alright. And spell recharge and lightning spells from any vendor. Well, that sucks. At least we know what it is. But yeah, no element spell vendor and a rare merchant. Well, let's just go for the rare merchant because we don't have enough money for the no element spells, even if I wanted to.